So hello everyone, this is Fiaura the Tank Girl, and right now we're actually doing a viewer Q&A. So the biggest Q&A I get is how do I make my videos? So what we have here are our World of Tanks replays, which we start, and then I use Fraps here to record those. Meanwhile, my face cam is actually recorded by this, Windows Movie Maker is recording my face cam. Now this makes two separate videos. To put these videos together, I use this program. Now, YouTube Movie Maker is free if you want to make videos under 6 minutes. Otherwise, you have to pay about $40 to unlock all of its features and everything. But while it's robust and user-friendly, it is not, very well programmed. So you can only really compile one video at a time or one segment of your video. So I can put the two videos together, but then if I have like another, so if I have like a Panther 2 video and the Tenru video from Sunday, I have to compile the Panther 2 video and the Tenru video separately. Otherwise, this program jams up and doesn't know what to do because it's interacting with two different movie engines. Now, once they've compiled through here, this is the first compile, and I changed the setting in here to 1080p. Maximize the quality of both and all those other wonderful things. And also this is where I add my text overlays. Just like that. And then I can drag this around the screen directly, and I can do the same thing with my face cam pip. Now once I'm done with this program, I close it out after it's compiled. Fraps would normally be closed, and I come into Premiere Pro. Now this program costs me $10 a month to use because it's a part of the Adobe Cloud. And this is part of what your patronage pays for. It pays for this program. In addition to the contests and prizes, the patronage page pays for this program, which you can find the patronage page both at the end of the video by clicking on the woman standing outside the IS-4 or by going into the description below. It's a monthly donation. You can donate as little as you want, but basically that's what pays for the channel. It pays for the use of this program. It paid for the use of YouTube, the purchasing of YouTube Movie Maker. It pays for the purchasing of Fraps. It pays for the contests I give out to you guys, because I don't get support from Wargaming or Obsidian Games or My.com. I have to pay for it. So anyway, I use this program to put them all together, so you can see the intro video is already here. I can drag in extra sound. This is also where I put in the music, and I can adjust the individual audio of everything. Now, once that's done, I then have to do another compile. So that's how I make my videos. Once another compile is done, I watch the video and make sure it's what I want, and then move on. So we're going to move on to actually answering some of your questions now. So in the meantime, let's bring up that replay. But your questions, basically I try to answer them as quickly as I can, but in this case it's been 3 weeks since we did the last viewer Q&A, and this is how to make videos. Sorry, I'm gonna go ahead and compile the screen capture. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and play it. But anyway, so this is how I make your videos once all that stuff's done. And it really, really does take quite a bit of time, and the World of Tanks thing up right now. Now the other thing I have to do for World of Tanks, which is so annoying, I have to keep multiple versions of World of Tanks on my computer. I have to keep a 9.4, a 9.5, a 9.6, and now a 9.7, because they keep changing the replay files slightly between each version, which means the previous version's replay files no longer work. Now I'm almost at the point I can get rid of the 9.4 because I'm almost out of 9.3 and 9.4 replays. But I have to keep all of those different replays on hand at all times. And what you guys are going to see for the World of Tanks part of this segment is a bunch, as you guys can see right now, it's a TOG driving around. You guys are going to see a bunch of user guest replays of tanks that I've already done, of them cruising around and just doing other random things. But that's how I make my videos. Those are the programs I use. There's a lot of tutorials on how to use those programs. If you want to learn, I suggest you go listen to the tutorials and do a lot of reading on the user manuals. I've done hours of reading on those user manuals to try to figure all this stuff out. So I'm going to take a sip and move on. Now, I've got a bunch of questions from you guys. And first off, I'm going to answer the World of Tanks ones, and then when we get through with those, I will start an Armored Warfare replay while I talk about Armored Warfare. What do I think of the new domination mode in World of Tanks? It's fun. It is a lot of fun. I wish it counted for something besides just extra credits and bragging rights, but it is a lot of fun. I particularly like playing around with the Object 140 and a platoon of them just wolfpacking around and racking up kills. Go play it. Seriously. I do have a complaint that Wargaming did not integrate the replay system into domination mode. So in order to put those replays up, I'm going to have to live record them in the coming week. So yeah, I will live record those for you guys so you guys can see the domination mode next week. I'll probably do the live recording this weekend. But yeah, they didn't do that. I'm kind of a little ticked off about it, because if you're going to have a replay system, at least make it where every game mode works. Something I need to ask you guys, do you prefer music or no music at all with the videos? If you don't prefer music, please say so. If you do prefer music, please say so. But let me know. I'm on the fence about whether to continue to have music in my videos, and I kind of need you guys' input. Now, the next question I have is, what do I think about the latest patch for World of Tanks? It was rushed. It's quite clear it was rushed. There's been a couple bugs show up that normally don't happen. And Wargaming needs to go in and fix the stuff quickly. It sucks that there are bugs, but it is how things go, and I guess that's just what we're gonna have to deal with until Wargaming fixes it. The next question is, what equipment should I choose for the ELC AMX BIS? Used to be just the ELC AMX. I would actually go with Vents, a laying drive, because you're going to have a long reload anyway, and you want to be able to shoot more accurately, and a set of optics, coated optics. That's what I would go with. Very simple question, very straightforward answer. The next question is, when am I going to get a new banner? I'm waiting on Sentinel Plays. I hope he sees this and hears this. I'm still waiting on him to send me the banner. He's kind of a week overdue, but stuff happens. I understand real life. Just let me know if you're going to finish it or if I need to commission somebody else to do it. Somebody else has already been commissioned to make a new avatar picture for me, and it looks like it's going to be here at the end of the week, which I've seen the sketch for it. It's adorable. So the last thing I'm going to explain while we're on the subject of World of Tanks is the forums. Now, I have had a bunch of trolls show up on the forums. On the World of Tanks forums, on the Watt Labs forums, and on the Armored Warfare forums. Now that the trolling is initially gone and out of the system, I'm actually going to start new threads. So this will be the last video in the old threads. I will start new threads with any videos past this one, because I'd rather not have the trolling issues, and I would rather, you know, the threads be about the video than about people coming in and trolling the hell out of them. If you guys want to help with the trollish situation, you can go on the WAP forums or the AW forums. The AW forums are not near as toxic, but there are definitely some trolls, and there are definitely people who are trying to make me look bad. And I found that the AW forums is a very heavy, and devs, if you're paying attention, your forums has a very heavy double standard you're letting go on, because people say things happen, and then I ask for screenshots, and they say they don't need them, and then I say something happens, and everybody demands screenshots of me. So there's a big double standard going on there, and it's quite obvious that it's just a bunch of male gamers who are basically like, that's a woman who doesn't know what the hell she's talking about. And there's a big double standard with the live streamers coming in and trashing my thread and then having to get moderated. The thread's been moderated, but I would rather not have, you know, posts in my video thread that say thread moderated. I'll just take those out and keep going. But yeah. So, that's about everything for World of Tanks. So while this TOG replay finishes up, we're going to move on to Armored Warfare. what is going on with Armored Warfare right now? Well, so far, the test, the week-long test, I have enjoyed thoroughly. There are some bugs. I mean, there are some bugs. Devs, please listen. But they're going to work out the bugs. As far as we know, they are going to take the time to work out the bugs, which I'm really hoping that that is actually going to be a thing, that they're going to take all the time to work out all these bugs and get everything fixed. Now, I'm going to go over a couple of the bugs that we've experienced with you guys right now. So, one, there is a bug with the gun mantles of most of the main battle tanks. Actually, most tanks in the game, there's a bug with their gun mantle. It doesn't exist! You get a green penetration when you scroll over tanks' gun mantles, and I fire high explosive rounds and they fly through the gun mantle. It's not supposed to happen. Gun mantles are supposed to be one of the strongest points on the tank, and yeah, the M60 Patton's gun mantles is chew throughable. The T62 and all of the Russian tank gun mantles so far have no armor whatsoever. HE rounds do full damage through the gun mantle. And there's just gun mantle doesn't work very well. I don't know what the point of the applique armor is on the Chieftain or the T72, but it's not working as intended. It is an armor downgrade. It's not an armor upgrade, devs. It's a downgrade. I played with the applique armor on my T72 tonight for 5 battles, after which I switched back to the standard armor, and the standard armor definitely works better. It works a lot better. You need to look at what's going on there. I think it's because you're changing the actual armor on the tank to standard steel instead of a composite, and it's reacting in some way that's basically making the tank weaker instead of stronger with the applique armors. So you may want to look into that one. There will be a swing fire video coming up tomorrow, and it will be in the new Armored Warfare thread on the Armored Warfare forums. Which, by the way, if you're watching this, please go on there and rate my video threads. If you're a fan of the channel, it would be really nice of you guys, because, again, there are trolls who are abusing the forum rating system and basically downrating any thread I post. They're not even leaving comments. They're just going in, and if I put something up, it immediately has 1 star, and which stands for the thread is terrible, and then can't get it above that because there's about 4 or 5 people who know that whatever they say is going to get moderated, so instead they just downrate the thread. The system's clearly being abused. And we said there wouldn't be a rating system. Well, there is a rating system, and it's being used for the wrong purposes. Anyway, if you guys want to help, you can go on there, you can rate the thread, and for the World of Tanks forums, both the NA and EU, I would appreciate it if you guys would go in and counteract some of the negative voting the trolls have been doing. What else? Oh, the missiles. So something else went wrong with Armored Warfare right now. Devs, the missiles are not tracking properly. The missiles instead are not locking onto tanks. They're locking onto the terrain behind the tank. I watched a swing fire shoot 25 missiles. I counted them when I went back and watched the replay. Out of his 25 missiles, 2 actually hit the target. The rest landed behind or on some piece of terrain near the target. I have had the same problem with my swing fire. I played a couple battles with it. I got a good recording to show the devs exactly what I'm talking about. But right now, the missiles are pretty bugged. If there's no terrain behind the tank, the missile doesn't even lock on. It just keeps flying straight into the sky. So devs, you may want to take a look at your missile aiming system. Are there any other major bugs that I can think of right now? Now, overall, the game is good and wonderful, and I've had a hell of a time in it. I've had a fun time with the main battle tanks. There are definitely some balance issues, particularly with the light tanks versus main battle tanks. The light tanks not having to aim when they're moving. Sheridans come by and do 500 damage at full speed, just auto-aiming and firing, and there's nothing we can do about it. I really think they should probably take a look at that. The Stingray, the main battle tanks just can't keep up with it. it's unless it's not paying attention to you, you're almost never going to hit it, because by the time your gun can aim in, it's already put a round into you and ducked away. And it does this repeatedly, and there's not a lot you can really do about it, but hope that somebody else helps you engage it. The only way I found to consistently kill light tanks right now is to have multiple people engage said light tank. But yeah, they're either main battle tanks need some help here, or because the main battle tank class still feels very underpowered and very very weak, particularly at tiers 3 and 4. And even the tier 5 T-72, while it's a monster versus other main battle tanks, and I'm having a load of fun with it versus other main battle tanks, if I'm not facing main battle tanks, I feel crippled. I'm too slow to catch things. My armor isn't strong enough to stop the Sheridan or the Stingray round consistent. The Stingray, I can't stop the round at all. And the Sheridan, the Sabo round on it just... it hurts. And I see it, and I realize that there's not a lot I can really do to fight it, beyond hope that he makes a mistake or I get a lucky RNG and he misses, because otherwise he's just going to keep... I can't catch him. He pops out and shoots. Okay, that's fine. But because he's popping out and shooting and doing a boatload of damage, and then it takes my gun so long to aim, and he doesn't even have to aim. He literally just bang and pulls away before... I even get him spot before he even renders. He's already fired at me. That's how quick the light tanks are pulling off shots. By the time I hear the words "he spotted," he hasn't even rendered on my screen yet. He's already found my tank outline and fired. So I don't know where he's coming from, but he knows exactly where I am, and the tank outline gives him the edge, whereas I have to wait until he materializes, and by the time he's materialized, he's already around the corner. So that's kind of what we're experiencing right now with the light tanks, is they're definitely just a little, their special ability's a little overpowered. I don't want to say it's super overpowered, because it's not. They are killable, but at the same time, the players who have tier 6s right now, and the players who have really high damage dealt versus damage received ratios, and really high see, I'm a good sport about dying. And really high KDRs are people that have just been running the Sheridan and the Stingray. Anyone who's been running main battle tanks has a good at them, has a tier 5 main battle tank, but does not have near the stats of people running the light tanks. I haven't personally been running it because I know it's overpowered. And while I could go around and just beat on people with my Sheridan all day long, it seems kind of pointless to do that and then, you know, not really have it available to test next patch, because we are keeping our progress until through the next patch. So that's kind of nice. But yeah, I'm just finding that as a main battle tank player, I don't stand a chance against light tanks. And the AFVs, I only stand a chance against if I can get them cornered. It really needs to be kind of explained to players what the different classes do, because I see a lot of AFV players who are hiding in the back and not actually moving up to spot or scout, or flat out refusing to spot or scout. So we'll see where that goes, but I would like to see more aggressive AFV players for sure, because right now they just seem too scared. I think that's about everything going on with Armored Warfare that I can think of as far as patches and stuff and things happening. There hasn't been anything real with World of Warships in a couple weeks now. The only thing that's been added are the American battleships. I'm starting to get a few more ships. We're going to have some new ships on Friday and Sunday as usual. So we'll see what that turns out to be. I'm definitely going to try to play the destroyers really hard during Friday's live stream. So if you want to join me and get in my division, I would appreciate it. I'm still a noob at World of Warships. It would be awesome of you guys, and I'm going to go learn how to play a destroyer. So somebody asked how I found the files for the World of Tanks, for the Armored Warfare Exposé. So I have 7-zip, and if you go into your armor, to your folder, so you go computer, I go C drive, games, Armored Warfare, my.com, beta, games, DK, and then there's a bunch of resource pack files. You can open those archives with 7-zip, and you can look at them. And you can see that there are folders for MBTs, AFVs, TDs, artillery, self-propelled mortars, all sorts of things. And you can just go in there and you can look at them. You can even open the files within those. And if you're good and savvy with computer code, you might be able to figure out the armament of those tanks just by reading. But again, Armored Warfare is still in... I wouldn't even call this closed beta yet. This is still technically an alpha build to me. So there are bugs, there are balance issues, there are placeholder modules, there are just things that haven't been done yet. One of the bugs is we can't shoot through cars. That's another one. I would really appreciate it if my Sabre round would fly through this little Toyota in front of me. It'd be nice, because, you know, that little Toyota shouldn't stop that at all. But yeah, those are the kind of things going on with Armored Warfare. I'm going to answer. Now we're going to get into all of your user questions. So we're going to start with this one. Am I a red versus blue watcher? I watched it during the first three and some into the fourth season. After that, the show kind of got stupid and off track and just didn't seem like it was there for comedy anymore. And they were trying to do something with it that was not to my liking. So I just kind of stopped watching it. I do watch Ruby. That comes out of Rooster Teeth. I keep up with that show very heavily. I'm waiting for season two. I'm waiting so hard for season two. But yeah, I don't really watch Red versus Blue anymore. Armored Warfare word on the Israeli Merkava. Yes, it is in development. It is not, however, at the top of their priority list right now. They need to get all the other tanks, such as the ones I give you in my expose, ready and out the gate. So the Merkava is confirmed is going to be in the game. It's been requested way too much. Also, you guys just... if you're watching this and you saw that side shot on that patent, then you know that, you know, that's a kind of a very steep angle. I shouldn't be able to penetrate that. But yeah, the Israeli Merkava is definitely been said that they are going to develop it and put it into the game. Why am I not looking forward to the Stingray? I'm not looking forward to the Stingray or the Sheridan because I'm going to play them mostly in the next test, and I am fully expecting them to be nerfed. There have been too many people complaining about them being overpowered. Even against Tier 5s and main battle tanks, they definitely seem like they rule the battlefield. And I'm consistently seeing Sheridans in Tier 4 matches having 4 and 5 kills and doing massive amounts of damage, whereas the main battle tanks are just not able to compete. They can't keep up with the tank. They can't hit it. Their aim times are far too long in order to actually engage it. If this went to Clan Wars right now, the Tier 4 Clan Wars would be who brings more Sheridans, and the Tier 6 Clan Wars would be who brings more Stingrays. That's what it would be. That's just how powerful those tanks are right now, and I'm not looking forward to it because they're probably going to get nerfed in some way, and I want to see what the nerfs are going to be before I make a declaration of the Scorpion or the Sheridan being awesome. The next question is, do I think the Founders Pack is worth the access? Yes. You're getting to play the game before everybody else, without having to wait on a random number generator to choose you. You're getting to, also get a bunch of stuff. That's why I'm buying you guys Founders Packs this month. Which the winner announcement will come probably, I'm going to say Sunday. Sunday's video will have the winner announcement in it because I have to review the entries that were picked and then pick two of them out of the 10 for the winners. So it's also your chance to help develop the game. So you're testing it, you're looking for balance issues, you're looking for things, and you can go tell the devs and give them plenty of feedback on how you feel about the game so far. And about how you feel about how the mechanics are working, about how the game is being developed. So yeah, it's worth it. If you really want influence in on the game, Obsidian is listening to everything we say. They really are. And I would say buy the Founders Pack. Go buy one. Plus, I mean, the way Obsidian's EULA reads, they have to, you know, finish the game. Unless they go bankrupt, they have to finish the game, and buying a Founders Pack would also help ensure they don't go bankrupt during the development process. So yeah, I really honestly think it is worth it. So the next question on the list of questions is, let's see here. What servers do I play on World of Tanks? So on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, I am normally on the North American server on East Coast. I can switch to West Coast. I do not mind doing that. But most of the time I'm on the East Coast. As far as the other day, Thursday, I am actually on the European One server. I spend my Thursdays on the EU One server playing with my European fans because you guys now make up 47% of my subscriber base and 44.8% of my viewer base is European, which is actually now more than my NA guys. NA guys, you're behind. The EU guys are surpassing you. So yeah, that's the two servers I play on. I normally play on NA East and EU One. I can play on EU Two, and I can also play on NA West. It's entirely up to you guys. A user sent in a bunch of colorful questions, and I figured I'll answer them all. What is your favorite color? Emerald green. What is your favorite movie? Bicentennial Man with Robin Williams. What is my favorite number? 72, for reasons. What is your favorite tank? Leopard 1, Leopard 1, Leopard 1, Leopard 1, Leopard 2. In that order. What is your favorite actor? Well, Robin Williams is my favorite actor. I know he's no longer with us. He's been an inspiration all my life. He's someone who's taught me to never give up and never stop something that I truly believe in. And I'm sad he's gone now. I did get to meet him once. It was at a very interesting place. I met him at a con in a game room. And I died laughing because he was playing. You're not going to believe this. He was at a con. In a tabletop games room, playing orcs for Warhammer 40K, and the way he was talking, you couldn't battle against him because you were laughing too much. So awesome person. Favorite stupid person on Earth. These questions were sent by Klaus Kellerman. I did not make up these questions. So my favorite people on Earth are my other half, Kyra. Hi, I know you're watching this. I know you see all of my videos and are absolutely faithful to watching everything I do. Wink, wink, hint, hint. If you do are actually watching this, leave a comment, Kyra. Let everyone know you exist. And a very close friend of mine who's like a sister to me, Roxy. And lastly is my adopted child, as I will call her. And if she sees this, she's gonna freak out because she knows who she is. I'm not gonna say her name. She'll have to figure it out, but I'll make sure this goes across her Facebook page and she'll know exactly who I'm talking about. So the next question: what do I have to do to be a guest star on your channel? Just a lot of damage? No. To be a guest star on my channel, there are a couple requirements. One, I'm probably gonna see the stats of the replay you send me before I actually watch the replay. I need to see that you've done damage, that you have some kills, because both things are important. I need to see that you've possibly earned the first class or the mastery badge. Those two things kind of have to happen. One of those things has to happen, period, and then you need to have some damage and some kills and or a lot of spotting. And then I'm gonna watch the replay. I actually spend almost as much time watching replays as I do actually playing the game now. That's gonna have to stop. I'm gonna have to create some actual standardized criteria. But while I'm watching the replay, you need to be showing me that you know how to play this tank and that I can use this replay to show others how to play that tank. What does that mean? That means that you're using a medium like a medium and taking advantage of its armor if it's an armored medium, or taking advantage of its mobility if it's not an armored medium, or how the tank's basically supposed to be played by via description, or a way in which you can play the tank and succeed. you need to be aggressive. Camp sniping is not an acceptable replay to me. I will not use it. I just flat out throw those out, because camp sniping encourages players to be campers, and I have always found that long-term campers have lower damage ratios and lower kill ratios, and therefore are actually worse at the game because they're not actually helping their team. Which brings me to the third criteria: you must be fighting to win and help your team, not for your individual stats or capability. I need to see that you're playing to win. So long as I'm seeing that, then it's probably going to get used. Now, I have a lot of World of Tanks replays right now and no World of Warships replays. So if you really want to be featured on the channel, send me some World of Warships replays. Because right now, I have so many World of Tanks replays sent by you guys that I literally just have to filter them out and go, which ones am I going to use, or am I going to do a double feature, or what am I going to do with all this? Because there's just so many that I honestly don't know what I'm going to do with all of them half the time. Actually, most of the time, I don't know what I'm going to do with all of them. So that's what it takes to get on my channel with your replay. Am I Canadian? No. Sometimes I wish I was, because I'm absolutely ashamed of my country, the United States, but let's not get into a political discussion or debate while attempting to play World of Tanks, or show you guys how to play World of Tanks. And the last question here: where do I go to college? Rutgers, actually. I go to Rutgers in New Brunswick, New Jersey, at the Department of Women and Gender Studies, where I am a specialist in human sexuality and cyber psychology. Cyber psychology basically meaning how the psychology of how people interact with each other on the internet. Those are the two things that I'm really focused in and really study. And my YouTube channel, believe it or not, guys, is fair use for my studies and for my research. So I do collect data from you guys. I hope you don't mind. If you do mind, I'm sorry. It is public domain, and I am technically a scientist first and a gamer second. So I guess I don't know what to tell you. I hope if you're angry about it, I'm sorry. Do know that when I do my research papers with public domain material, I only reference where you can find said material. I do not actually label people's individual names without asking them first. Otherwise, you get put in as anonymous, because that's to respect you and your privacy. That's actually all of your questions that I could come across between in the last 3 weeks. I will give a status of the channel as of right now. We are up 106 subscribers in a week. The Armored Warfare beta test just swelled the subscriber base by a huge amount in a week, and it's still growing. I wake up every morning and there's at least one or two more already there, and then by the end of the test, there's anywhere from 4 to 30. The first day of testing, I went from 630 to 680 as soon as I put up the first day's video. And I will continue to put up videos between now and the end of the next test. I have plenty of footage to put up a video every single day between now and the end of test, and almost enough footage to put up a different tank every single day, which you guys will see a lot of different tanks. There's technically only, I think, 31, 32 tanks in the test right now. So they're going to be unleashing Tier 7. And there's two full dealers that have not been revealed yet. So I'm imagining that we're looking at about 70 to 80 vehicles at game launch, with more on the way. I think that's about everything for you guys. I hope you've enjoyed this little Q&A. And if you have more questions, please don't hesitate to ask. I will do my best to answer all of those questions that you guys send me. I love interacting with you guys, as you guys know, and I do everything in my power to have a banter with you guys, have a flirt with you guys, talk with you guys, have some time with you guys. I cannot continue to promise that I will answer every single comment, because I actually missed two. I actually missed two comments. It happened finally. I simply have run out of time I don't have enough hours in the day. Sad as it is, I do not have enough hours in the day to answer all of your comments. But I try my best and will continue to try my best. Now, what I would like from you guys is, if you don't mind, continue to share my videos. Help me out on the forums, as I asked earlier. Continue to share my videos. Continue to like and comment and do it, and help the channel and grow this into a big... I want to grow this into a big community, into a bunch of people who are very helpful, who go out of their way to help other players, to kind of reduce some of the toxicity that we all see, that we talk about, but a lot of people don't do anything about. Well, guess what? That's what part of this channel is about, is reducing the toxicity. And having a place that you guys know you can go to, and a community you can go to, and talk about things, and relate to each other, and even if you can't really relate to the experience, you can at least be nice to the other person, and help the other person understand so they can be a better tanker, and just be better at video games in general. Now, the next game I'm going to add to the channel, there's two little things left, and then this Q&A, and then this this status of the channel, and the Q&A is all over. There's two things I want to add. There's two games that I'm choosing between to add to the channel. We're not really two so much as two ideas. So the first one is MechWarrior Online. Now, the problem with MechWarrior Online is I will have to do live recordings. The game is still not super optimized for anyone who has less than a 4.2 gigahertz processor. And it will take a huge time requirement in order to get my skill back up. I did have an amazing skill level when I left MechWarrior Online. I left because I was disgusted at the clan mechs. They were just disgusting to me at the time, and I didn't want to have to fight them or deal with them. But before that, I'd been in the first three tournaments that ever happened on MechWarrior Online. I was a participant. In the third tournament, my team actually made it all the way to the semifinals as the Templars, but I've just been out of the game so long it would take a huge time requirement. The other option is to add back Sunday Break. What Sunday Break was I would go through my Steam list and pick a game on my Steam list, and I have a very long Steam list now because my birthday, I got a bunch of different games, and do a recording and put it up. Now, it wasn't very popular because at the time I had really crappy video quality and a lot of people didn't know about my channel. So those are kind of the two options. If we're going to do my Steam list, I'm actually going to start with Tropico 5 because I have a lot of fun with Tropico. So we're going to start with Tropico 5, possibly do some, I'll probably start, also do Darkest Dungeon, and there's just a load of games. And what I'll start doing is, and I'll give you guys the full vote at the end of this, so yeah, that's what I'm looking at doing. So, the things you guys need to tell me: do you want music with your replays or not? Yes or no? This is your poll. Answer in the comments below. 2, do you want me to go back to MechWarrior Online, or do you want me to go do Sunday Breaks and show off a bunch of Steam games? Not that I mind in the slightest showing off all my going through my Steam library and playing a different game every week, or playing the same game to do a series. But that's up to you guys. So you guys need to let me know one of those two things. And now we come to the end, where I'm going to give shoutouts. So, first off, thank you, Sakura! And there's going to be a link to everyone's YouTube channel in the description below, so you can go check these people out. There's also going to be annotations up all over the place to check out these people right now. Thank you, Sakura, for showing me how to get those files, and how to use those files, and thank you for letting me go to Jinx and ask about the expose. Thank you very much. I hope you guys go check out Sakura's channel. Handies, this is a shout out to you. I'm gonna put this up on. Make sure you get this message that I'm giving you a shout out. I would like one back. Because we agreed to do this for each other. We didn't manage to link up and get platooned. I'm kind of sad at that, but I don't know, maybe I'll catch you on World of Tanks, or I'll catch you on the next test and we'll actually be in a platoon together. Ranger 1, your channel is called Virtual Realms. Thank you for platooning with me. I hope you learned something. I learned a couple things I didn't know before, and it was actually kind of helpful and helped me get my T-72. So I hope that I was helpful to you as well. I hope it was fun. I hope we can do it again. I hope maybe I'll catch you on live stream and we can go do something on live stream. So that's out to Ranger 1. Also, tomorrow or today, we will be seeing Gaming Bear and Lord Chipmunk again on live stream, and we will be having a fun old time on live stream with those two like we have done for the past couple weeks before Armored Warfare testing started. So I will see Gaming Bear and Lord Chipmunk technically tomorrow for me, but today for you guys. A shout out to both of them. Thank you for giving me shout outs for your channels. Here's your official Fiaura shout out. Hey guys, you're awesome. I think that's everything, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this Q&A from me, Fiaura the Tank Girl, and I hope to see you all Friday and on live stream later today on the EU server, and I hope to see you all Saturday for fan platoons on World of Tanks. So that's everything, and for right now, this is Fiaura the Tank Girl officially signing out, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye. Thank y'all for watching. If you like the video, then please shoot the like button in the face like a pro. If you want to talk with Fiaura or comment on the video, please leave a comment. I'll reply as soon as I possibly can. Want to help the channel out? Share this on your social media like Facebook or Twitter, or go post it on your favorite forum. If you would like to know when I'm live streaming, you can either go look at my Twitch channel and follow it, or you can go to Twitter. Every time I start the live stream, there's a tweet that goes up that lets you know I started. If you want to see more, please subscribe. You're always welcome in Fiora's house, and check out some of these other videos here for you to enjoy. If you want to support the channel, I ask that you click on the ad at the end of this video. YouTube pays its creators for your clicks, and every time you do that, you are showing support for your favorite YouTubers. You can also look in the description or click on the woman outside the IS-4 tank and go to the patronage page to donate directly. Remember, I base all my contests on your patronage, so basically all that money that gets put in gets thrown right back out to you guys. In the meantime, this is Fiaura the Tank Girl signing off, and I will see you in the next video.